Police officers in Coffs Harbour have smashed a woman's car window. Have a look at this. They dragged her out of the vehicle after she refused to comply with an officer's request. The woman and her male passenger argued they were not in the officer's jurisdiction and were not driving, but rather travelling in the area.
You guys don't even know what yous are on about.
I need your most senior on duty.
You don't have any jurisdiction on this land. Oh, look out.
You're under arrest.
You're a prick.
Yep.
Man, I would love to just get you one-on-one.
Okay, so New South Wales police say the 52-year-old woman allegedly had two outstanding arrest warrants. She was charged with refusing to provide officers with her details and refusing to undergo a breath test plus other charges. For more, I'm joined by a former New South Wales magistrate and Dean of Law at Southern Cross University, David Helpern. David, good morning to you. You've dealt with a lot of these kinds of people before the courts before. They're called sovereign citizens. What's their belief?
Look, their core belief were established in that video, that they are sovereign citizens, that they're not subject to the laws that the rest of us are subject to, that the Queen's not the Queen, that police aren't really legitimate police and that courts aren't legitimate courts, and that somehow by way of a contract or otherwise they've separated themselves completely from the laws of the land.
It's concerning, isn't it? It's believed the killers who shot dead two police officers and a civilian last month in regional Queensland frequented conspiracy websites and also had this sovereign citizen view. Do you think there's been an increase in this kind of thinking? And how dangerous can it be?
Look, there's a spectrum. At one end, there's those who just want to challenge the law and raise old common law doctrines and issues, and that's a positive thing. I think challenging the law is important and sensible, and it's how laws change. But at the other end of the spectrum is the hardcore believers in sovereign citizenship or pseudo-law, where they don't see themselves at all as bound by the law. They see the law as having absolutely no authority. And the hard edge is a dangerous edge. The Oklahoma bomber was a straw man sovereign citizen in the United States. There have been people charged, I know, in various rural areas of New South Wales with a variety of serious threatening and offences, and are in jail now for the threats that sometimes accompany this. And in that video, I think we saw it pretty clearly that the police officer said, quite a few times, I want your license, I'll break the window if you don't, and there it goes. Mm.
It seems obvious, doesn't it, why she wanted to stay in the car. Has there been any success of these so-called sovereign citizens fighting their claims in court?
Well, despite what the websites say and despite what some people who follow this pseudo-law sovereign citizenship say, there has not been a single successful case in any jurisdiction throughout Australia. It's obvious when you think about it for a second that you can't just remove yourself from the law by some sort of putting your names in capital or declaring yourself a sovereign citizen. It just simply is, it's gobbledygook. Mm. And the courts have treated it as such time after time. But it doesn't stop the adherents, particularly in traffic matters, from making these pretty bizarre claims.
Well, nice to know it hasn't been successful so far. David, thanks for joining us.